Hello students, this is Jai Kishan and in this part of the video we are going to start class 9th chapter 1, that is number system. Basically in this part of the video we will cover the introduction of the number system and the exercise first of chapter 1 from NCERT. Now we are coming to our first topic, that is basic definitions, the definition that you have studied in the previous classes, but here also you have to study once again. Okay, so our first definition is of natural numbers. What are natural numbers? Natural numbers is simply, you can say that counting numbers. Okay, counting number that starts from 1, whenever you start counting, you start from 1, to 1, 2, 3 and so on till plus infinity. So this collection is known as counting numbers as well as natural numbers. Okay, the second topic is whole numbers. What are whole numbers? If we include 0 to the set of natural number, if we include 0 to the set of natural number, means 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on till infinity, then this collection will be known as whole number. Okay, now integers. What are integers? So in the collection of integers there is 0, natural numbers 1, 2, 3 and so on till positive infinity, and the negatives of natural number, means minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and so on till negative infinity. If the collection is like natural numbers with the positive signs, with the negative signs together with 0, then this collection is known as integers. Okay, the collection of integers can be divided into two parts, that is z plus and z minus. What is z plus? If we take the collection of positive integers that start from 1, 1, 2, 3 and so on till positive infinity, then this collection is known as positive integers. Negative integers, that is z minus, in this collection the numbers are like minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and so on till negative infinity. This collection is known as negative integers. Then what about 0? Okay, we have seen that 1, 2, 3 and so on till positive infinity is positive integers. Minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and so on till minus infinity is negative integers. Then what about 0? If someone asks you that 0 is what, positive integers or negative integers, so your answer will be simply you can give your answer that 0 is neither a positive nor a negative number. 0 is neutral. 0 is a neutral number. Okay, now the collection of rational number, okay, and we denote rational number as q for quotient. Okay, the definition of rational number is all that numbers which can be represented in the form of p by q, where q is not equal to 0 and p and q are integers. Okay, all that numbers which can be represented in the form of p by q, where q should not be equal to 0, and one more condition is there, that p and q should be integers, then this collection is known as rational number. Okay, now see, in p by q, p is numerator and q is denominator. So the condition is that the denominator should not be equal to 0. Any number which can be like this, 2 upon 0, 3 upon 0, it is indeterminate. Okay, means this is infinity. You cannot define it. It is undefined. Okay, except these kinds of number, all that numbers which can be written in the form of p by q are rational numbers. Okay, like if I have written only 1, then it is also rational number because 1 by 1 you can write. ठीक है, इफ आई हैव रिटन 0, 0 इज व्हाट, रेशनल और इरेशनल, तो वी कैन राइट 0.1, 0.2, 0.3. ओके, द वैल्यू ऑफ 0 विल नॉट बी अफेक्टेड इफ आई हैव रिटन लाइक दिस. तो दिस इज ऑल्सो अ रेशनल नंबर. नाउ कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, इरेशनल नंबर. तो इट इज अपोजिट ऑफ रेशनल नंबर. वी कैन सी दैट ऑल दैट नंबर विच कैन नॉट बी रिटन इन द फॉर्म ऑफ rational number, like all that numbers which cannot be written in the form of p by q is known as irrational number. Okay, now real numbers. Real numbers are what? Real numbers, all the numbers which can be shown on the number line. The simple definition of the real numbers, that all that numbers which can be shown on the number line is known as real numbers. You have studied natural number, whole number, integers, rational, irrational. All these kinds of number can be represented on number line. So that you can say that the collection of all these is known as real numbers. Okay. Now coming to the next topic. Next heading is prime numbers. Prime numbers, the definition is numbers which are having only two factors, 1 and the number itself. These kinds of number is known as prime numbers. Like if I have given you the number 5, to see the 5 have only two factors, 1 and the number itself means 5. So this number will be known as prime number. Okay, 17. 17 is also having two factors, 1 and the number itself, that is 17. All that type of numbers which are having only two factors, the number 1 and the number itself, is known as prime numbers. Okay, in the composite number, just opposite of that, if the number is having more than two factors, then that numbers will be known as composite number. Like if I have given you the example of 9, 9 is the example of composite number because it is having its factor like 1, 3 and 9 also. So it is having more than two factors, then this is the example of composite number. Okay, like if I have given you the 21, the 21 is having factors 1, 3, okay, 7, 21. More than two factors are there, this number is also a composite number. The smallest composite number is 4. Okay, and the smallest prime number is 2. Now see, the co-prime numbers. What are the co-prime numbers? Pair of numbers having their HCF as 1. Basically, we denote the composite number, co-prime numbers, as like A, B. Two numbers written in the form of like this, and their HCF should be like 1. Their HCF should be 1. Like if I have given the, if I will give the example 3,5. 3 is having two factors 1 and 3. 5 is having two factors 1 and 5. The only common factor is 1. Okay. So the numbers which are having their HCF as 1, pair of numbers which are having their HCF as 1, then these kinds of number are co-prime numbers. Perfect square number. Perfect square number, simply you can say like 4. 4 is the square of 2. 9. 9 is the square of 3. So these kinds of number which are perfect square is known as perfect square numbers. Our next topic is decimals. Decimal means the number like 2.35, 5.2197, like this. These kinds of number which are having decimal points are known as decimals. Okay. Decimals can be divided in the two parts, like terminating and non-terminating. Those decimals which are getting terminate after few places of decimal is known as terminating decimal. Like example 2.3, 1.45, 0.565. So these are the examples of terminating decimal, because the number is getting terminate after few places of decimals. Now in non-terminating, the numbers which do not terminate after the few places of decimal, like 4.13257915, ठीक है, these are not terminating after the decimal point. So these are the numbers is called non-terminating number. Non-terminating can also be divided in the two parts. The first part is recurring or repeating decimals. Okay, what kind of numbers? The numbers like which repeat itself, like 2.33333 and so on. It is repeating. Simply we can write it like 2.3 bar. The block of number which is getting repeated, you can represent it like on bar. Like 5.141414 is repeating. So you can simply write it like 5.14 bar. Okay. Now non-repeating or non-recurring decimals like 2.13572598 1402. The number is non-terminating as well as it is not having any pattern or any repeating block. So these kinds of number are non-repeating or non-recurring. Okay, once again you have to see that decimals are divided in the two parts, terminating and non-terminating. Terminating, the numbers which are getting terminate after the few places of decimals, and non-terminating, the numbers are not getting terminate after the decimal point. Non-terminating can be divided in the two parts, recurring or repeating, and non-recurring or non-repeating. Now see, these parts, the numbers, the examples of these two parts can simply changed in the form of P by Q. How we will change, we will see in the next part of this video. Okay, but these examples can be changed in the form of P by Q, so we can simply say that these numbers are rationals. Okay, and this part we cannot change in the form of P by Q, so this is irrational number. The one more definition, except the definition you have given earlier, that the numbers which cannot be written in the form of P by Q, ठीक है, here one more definition you can give of irrational number, that the number, the decimals which are non-repeating or non-recurring and non-terminating number is known as irrational numbers. Okay, now this is the overview, that all the definition you have studied, classifications of numbers. Numbers can be divided in the two parts, real numbers and imaginary numbers. Real numbers, the definition of real numbers you have studied. What is the imaginary numbers? Imaginary numbers, like if the number is negative in the square root. Okay, like you know that 4 is the square of 2, but you cannot find the square root of minus 4. Okay, so this part, imaginary numbers, you will see in class 11th. Okay, here only, here you have to see only this part, that real numbers again can divide it in the two parts, rational number and irrational number. Rational number, the numbers which can be written in the form of P by Q. Irrational number, which cannot be written in the form of P by Q. Rational number again can be divided in the two parts, fractions and integers. Fractions like 2/3, 0.14, the decimals are the parts of fraction. Okay, as well as you can write it like 2/3 and 0.14 also. Integers, you have seen the collection of integers like 1, 2, 3 and so on, infinity. And here -1, -2, -3 and so on till minus infinity. Integers can also be divided in the two parts, that is z minus and z plus. z plus is 1, 2, 3 and so on till infinity. If we include 0 with the z plus, this collection will be known as whole numbers. And here z minus, you know that minus 1, minus 2, minus 3 and so on till negative infinity. Okay, now the whole number means that if you include 0 with z plus, then it will be changed into whole number. The whole number can also be divided in the two parts, 0 and natural number. So it was the classification of numbers. Okay, somewhere you can see that somewhere is given the example like natural number, which is the smallest list. If 0 you will include, then it is whole number. Okay, if you will put negatives of natural number, then this collection is integers. Now this is the collection of rational numbers, which can be written in the form of phi by q. If irrational number you will include here, then this whole collection is of real numbers. Okay, now we are going to see the first exercise of this chapter. Before starting the exercise, one point we should note that there are infinitely many rational numbers between any two given rational numbers. What does it mean? It means that if the two rational numbers are given, then we can find infinitely many rational numbers between them. Okay, and the formula to find one rational number between any two rational number is, suppose x is any rational number, y is any rational number, and we want to find the rational number between x and y. So we can apply the formula x plus y by 2. Okay, for example, if 3 is a rational number and 4 is a rational number, and we want to find a rational number between 3 and 4, so we can apply the formula like x plus y by 2, means 3 plus 4 by 2, and simply we'll get 7 by 2. So 7 by 2 is a rational number between 3 and 4. Now coming to the exercise, the first question of exercise 1.1, this is from NCERT. Okay, the first question of exercise 1.1 is 0 a rational number? Can you write it in the form of p by q when p and q are integers and q is not equal to 0? To see, earlier we have seen that 0 is what? 0 is what? 0 can be written in the form of p by q, like 0 by 1, 0 by 2. There will be no effect on the value of 0. Okay, all will these will be equal to 0. Means 0 is a rational number. It can be written in the form of p by q, and where denominator should not be equal to 0. What if the denominator is equal to 0, then this value will be infinite. Okay, this is undefined and it will be infinite. So this you cannot write, because here it is given that q is not equal to, q should not be equal to 0, means denominator should not be equal to 0. Okay, otherwise you can write 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 0.10, 0.20, whatever you have written. Okay, so 0 is a rational number. It can be written in the form of p by q. The second question is to find 6 rational numbers between 3 and 4. You have to find 6 rational numbers between 3 and 4. To see, if you will apply the formula x plus y by 2, okay, then you have to apply this formula till 6 times. 6 times, because you have to find 6 rational numbers. Okay, so it is very long process that you will apply this formula 6 times. So I will tell you one more simple method, and from that method you can find not only 6, not only 10, even 100, 1000, whatever the numbers are given. Okay, you can find 1000 rational numbers between 3 and 4, 100 rational number, whatever the question is given. So what is the method? See, you have to find 6 rational numbers. Here you have to find 6 rational numbers between 3 and 4. Okay, 3, if we will write 3 upon 1 and 4 upon 1, there will be no difference, ठीक है। नाउ सी द गैप ऑफ थ्री एंड फोर, द गैप ऑफ थ्री, ऑफ थ्री एंड फोर इज ओनली वन, ओके, मतलब थ्री टू फोर, ठीक है, देर इज नो गैप। सो एंड यू, एंड यू हैव टू फाइंड सिक्स रेशनल नंबर्स, तो सो यू हैव टू इंक्रीज द गैप ऑफ थ्री एंड फोर। हाउ यू विल इंक्रीज, तो मल्टीप्लाई इट बाई टेन अपॉन टेन, मल्टीप्लाई इट बाई टेन अपॉन टेन। नाउ वॉट यू विल गेट, थर्टी अपॉन टेन एंड फोर्टी अपॉन टेन, ओके। नाउ सी दीज टू नंबर्स, थर्टी अपॉन टेन एंड फोर्टी अपॉन टेन, देयर डिनोमिनेटर्स आर इक्वल, टेन एंड टेन, एंड द न्यूमरेटर्स आर थर्टी एंड फोर्टी। नाउ यू कैन फाइंड द गैप ऑफ टेन इन बिटवीन थर्टी एंड फोर्टी, ओके। सो इन दीज टू यू कैन राइट सिक्स रेशनल नंबर्स लाइक थर्टी वन अपॉन टेन, थर्टी टू अपॉन टेन, थर्टी थ्री अपॉन टेन, थर्टी फोर अपॉन टेन, थर्टी फाइव अपॉन टेन एंड थर्टी सिक्स अपॉन टेन। तो यू कैन राइट योर आंसर लाइक दिस, ओके। नॉट ओनली सिक्स रेशनल नंबर, इफ द क्वेश्चन वर फाइंड सिक्सटी रेशनल नंबर्स बिटवीन थ्री एंड फोर, तो ओनली यू हैव टू इंक्रीज मोर गैप, तो फॉर दैट यू हैव टू ओनली मल्टीप्लाई इट बाई वन मोर टेन अपॉन टेन एंड टेन अपॉन टेन, देन योर न्यूमरेटर्स, देन योर न्यूमरेटर्स वुड बी थ्री हंड्रेड एंड फोर हंड्रेड, देन ईजली यू कैन फाइंड द गैप ऑफ सिक्सटी, ओके। नाउ कमिंग टू द नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज फाइंड फाइव रेशनल नंबर्स बिटवीन थ्री बाई फाइव एंड फोर बाई फाइव। बेसिकली वेन एवर द क्वेश्चन इज गिवन लाइक दिस, लाइक इन द फॉर्म ऑफ पी बाई क्यू, तो फर्स्टली यू हैव टू सी देयर डिनोमिनेटर्स, इफ द डिनोमिनेटर्स आर इक्वल देन देयर इज नो प्रॉब्लम, ठीक है, यू कैन सॉल्व द क्वेश्चन ईजली, लाइक थ्री बाई फाइव एंड फोर बाई फाइव इज गिवन, एंड यू हैव टू फाइंड फाइव रेशनल नंबर्स बिटवीन दीज टू। तो डिनोमिनेटर्स आर सी, देन सी देयर न्यूमरेटर्स थ्री एंड फोर, देयर इज नो गैप ऑफ फाइव, तो यू हैव टू इंक्रीज द गैप्स, and for increasing the gaps you have to multiply it by 10 and 10, so your this number will be changed like 30 upon 50 and this number will be 40 upon 50. Now denominators are again same, so in between 30 and 40 you can find the five rational numbers like 31 upon 50, 32 upon 50, 33 upon 50, 34 upon 50 and 35 upon 50, okay. Again this is a very easy question. Now what if the denominators are different, the question is not given, but one example I want to give you, that if the denominators are not equal then what you will do. If the denominators are not equal, suppose the question is given find five rational numbers between 1 by 2 and 2 by 3. Here the denominators are what? 2 and 3 means different. Then what you will do? Then for this condition, firstly we will find the LCM of denominators, means LCM of 2 and 3. So LCM of 2 and 3 will be what? 6. Okay. Now we will change our numbers in the denominator of 6. 1 by 2. If we want to change its denominator as 6, we have to multiply it by 3. So if we are multiplying the denominator 3, then we have to multiply the numerator also, then it will be 3 upon 6. Here also, if we want to change the denominator as 6, then we have to multiply it by 2 upon 2. 3 2s are 6. So it will be 4 upon 6. Now our numbers are 3 upon 6 and 4 upon 6. Now the denominators are same and we want to find 5 rational numbers between them, 3 by 6 and 4 by 6. So only we have to increase the gaps. So how we will increase the gaps? By multiplying it by 10 upon 10. 10 upon 10. So this 3 upon 6, when it will be multiplied by 10 upon 10, so it will be 30 upon 60. And when it will be multiplied, it will be 40 upon 60. Okay, now in 30 and 40, easily you can find 5 rational numbers like 31 upon 60. Okay, 32 upon 60. 33 upon 60. 34 upon 60. And 35 upon 60. Okay, only you have to take firstly the LCM of denominators, then you have to change the number as its denominator of like LCM. Okay, and then you have to increase the gap according to the given question. Okay, now coming to the next question. Next question, question number 4 is, state whether the following statements are true or false. Give reasons for your answers. So if you have studied the definitions well, you can simply give the answers. Like the first part of this question is, every natural number is a whole number. The set of natural number was what? Natural number starting, it is counting number, so starting from 1, 2, 3 and so on till infinity. And the whole numbers was what? Whole numbers 0, 1, 2, 3 and so on until infinity. Theek hai? Question is, every natural number is a whole number. It is true or false? So you can see 1, 2, 3 and so on till infinity. Here also 1, 2, 3 and so on till infinity. Means every natural number is a whole number. This statement is true. Okay. Now, every integer is a whole number. Every integer is a whole number. The collection of z was what? Negative infinity, minus 3, minus 2, minus 1, 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on, positive infinity. Okay, this is the collection of z. And the collection of whole number is what? 0, 1, 2, 3, and so on till infinity. So here you can see that in the collection of integers, negatives of natural number are also there. And in the collection of whole number, only positive numbers together with 0 are there. Okay, positive natural numbers together with 0 are there. So how you can say that every integer is a whole number? Because in the collection of integers, negatives are also there. So this statement is false. Okay, reason you will write, because in the collection of integers, negatives of natural numbers are also there. Okay, now the third part is, every rational number is a whole number. You know very well that rational number is in the form of p by q. Okay, where q should not be equal to 0. And in whole number, the numbers are only like this. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4 and so on till infinity. So if 1 by 2, someone write that 1 by 2 is a rational number, can it be a whole number? So no, it cannot be whole number, because in the collection of whole number, only these kinds of number are there. And also, rational number can be negative, but in whole number, only positives together with 0 are there. Positive natural numbers together with 0 are there. So this statement is also false. Okay. So I think this is enough for this part of the video. Our exercise 1.1 is completed. For exercise 1.2, we will see in the next part of the video. Okay. Thank you.